Thousands of Muslims flocked Chibuli Mosque today to celebrate Eid al-Fitri, which marks the end of the holy month of Ramadan. Security was on high alert as checkpoints were mounted to all access points. In his sermon, Sheikh Mohammed Chigundu, the spokesperson of Chibuli faction, emphasized the importance of celebrating Eid and the purpose of paying zakat before Eid prayers.
Fulfilling part of the section of what we are supposed to do after fulfilling the prayer of
Chigundu decried the skyrocketing prices of essential commodities that have made it difficult for some Islamic faithfuls to fulfill the pillar of fasting.
Many people have not been able to access what they feel they can have to break their fast and to have even soul. But alhamdulillah, you've been able to do that. Why then aren't you thankful to Almighty Allah that He has enabled you to go through this whole life that has been too tough on you?
The Supreme Mufti Sheikh Mohammed Galabuzi, who presided over his first Eid prayers at Chibuli, asked government to reverse the controversial coffee agreement with Uganda Vinci Coffee Company, which is creating a monopoly on the coffee sector. Galabuzi wondered how an investor who has failed to deliver on Lubowa International Specialized Hospital was trusted with another deal.
The person who was given the responsibility of constructing Lubowa Hospital has failed to deliver. We wouldn't want another deal to be handed to them. We may think that we are moving forward and later realize that we are moving backwards.
After prayers, the titular head of Muslims, Dr. Kasim Nachibinjeka Kunglu, hosted different dignitaries to a luncheon at his home in Chibuli, including the U.S. Ambassador to Uganda, Natalie Brown, Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, Deputy Katikiro of Buganda Kingdom, Haj Tuahwa Kawase, among others. Nachibinja took on the government on escalating prices of household commodities and called for serious interventions. He faulted the government for leaving the crisis for the market forces of demand and supply, which can't cushion the situation.
Despite the rising costs of some of the essential commodities, but at least we are alive. We only pray to those charged with the economic affairs of the country to see what they can do about the rising costs of these essential commodities. They have to take the bitter pill and maybe revisit some of the tariffs of some of those essential commodities that are causing us issues.
Prince Nachibinja tasked police and other security agencies to investigate the spate of machete wielding attackers that have resumed attacks in Kampala metropolitan areas, hacking people to death. He also expressed concern over fires gutting schools, saying these fires have elements of arson and need to be investigated and perpetrators brought to book.
After the COVID, schools were opened, but it is very disheartening. Some of these schools have been set ablaze. I wish to ask police and the security organs in the country to investigate the causes of these problems in these schools. Who is setting them ablaze? I don't believe it's an accident. I believe this is arsenal of the highest order.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Kampala.